Luocheng County in China's south is known for its mountains, its rivers, and its poverty. Chen Shouzhi was among those once struggling to get by. Living in this dilapidated house, she struggled to raise enough money to send her two children to school. But she says thanks to the Chinese government, her life has been transformed. She's been given a new home in town and left this old farmhouse behind.
This is how most people here used to live, in crumbling buildings built about 50 years ago, without any water or electricity. This area is also deep in the mountains and far away from any essential services, including hospitals.
During the past 5 years, millions of people in rural China have been relocated to apartment buildings in upgraded townships. Here, almost everything is new, including the roads and the schools. Chen moved here in 2018.
My son told me that he doesn't want to go back to the old house again. It was dark and dirty and had many rats. They say our new home is clean and bright.
Beijing has spent more than $20 billion this year to meet President Xi Jinping's deadline of eradicating extreme poverty nationwide by the end of 2020. Communist Party officials say they've succeeded.
People used to have few options. Roads were bad. It was hard to find jobs outside farming. Good health care and education were scarce. Now they basically live in the same conditions as people in cities. The quality of life has rapidly improved.
But not everyone has benefited. Some have been unable to adjust to life in the towns. Others say they've been forced to relocate. Analysts have also questioned the sustainability of the program, saying millions risk falling back into poverty.
Poverty by nature, for many people, is transient. It's temporary. It's short-term spells. And those kinds of people have very, very different kinds of needs than others for whom poverty is a chronic experience. The policy response to those different states needs to be different.
Chen Shouzhi says life is better, but not easier. Her new job in a nearby factory involves working 12 hours a day with only 2 days off per month. But the sacrifice, she says, is worth it. She's making the most of the new opportunities in the hope her children might have better ones. Katrina, Aljazeera, Luocheng County, China.